That's Michael Siggins from Robotics Trends, and I'm here with Bruno from SciRobo and InnoRobo. How are you, Bruno?
I'm good, thank you very much. A little tired, but I'm fine.
Tired? How can you be so tired? What's going on around here?
Well, we've been preparing this summit for a month now, and we're very proud to see that build it and they came. They effectively came. We have more people than expected. We have 70 booths. We have 100 service robots displayed on the floor, on which probably 20, 25 we have never seen before. Mm-hmm. So it's a great achievement. In all sectors of service robotic, transportation, education, we have medical, and we have leisure, entertainment, so it's fun. We have a lot of things, including domestic with iRobot.
Now, were you surprised at how much vendor participation and vendor interest there was in the event?
I have to say yes, I was surprised, but we were kind of smart because we identified two big things. First, that most of the service robotic company are small. Mm-hmm. So what we did look for sponsors, and we cut them a good deal. We said, instead of just having your logo on the same paper again, why don't you just organize a booth where we could host five or six startups in service robotics? Mm-hmm. They like the idea. That's why we're having big energy company, big transportation company, big insurance company hosting small companies. Mm-hmm. That's the diversity of the show. That's why you see so many robots today.
Okay. Now, why do these companies want to be here? What do they want to get out of this event?
I think it's a blend of public exposure. They want to be in contact with the real people and see if their dreams make sense. Secondly, they want to establish international business contact. We have a huge Korean presence with more than 15 booths. And they do talk to some French or American other people. So international connection is important. And lastly, we have some distributor investors coming. The investors, they look for investment. And they finally realize robotic might be the new internet. So they like this idea, and the distributors, they look for product, and they say, maybe this could go on my shelves. So that's how we go.
And I know later in the event, you're going to have a number of students that are going to be coming here, a huge number of students. What do you think the students and their teachers hope to get out of coming to this event?
Well, what I hope is that they get hooked, and they get the virus, the robotic virus, because in Europe, we're missing huge numbers of roboticians. People are doing computing, they're doing mechanic, they're doing a lot of things which are related to robotic. But effectively, the pure specialty in robotic is still at the early stage at school. So I hope that those teachers, those president of universities or the student realize the potential of robotic and then can open sections in their schools to teach robotic.
Okay, and now the focus is on service robotics. Do you see other segments in the robotics industry that you want to go after and build the same level of excitement with?
You know, if I look at what CAR did, the Korean Association did, after a couple of years, they merged industrial robotic and service robotic. We're not there yet, but I think that the trend is rational. At one point, it's just about robotics. And the division today is between, let's call it the manufacturing robotic and the others. We all know the segmentation is purely virtual, but the sizes of the company are different. So let's grow these little startups and this little service company up. And so when we'll be in a better par, I think we'll be combining probably energy and strengths.
Okay. And if you would like to send a message out to robotics companies, ones that are maybe just trying to get their start, or entrepreneurs with a new idea, what would you encourage those entrepreneurs to do?
I would definitely tell them that we have now built a nest for them to be exposed. The SciRobo Association is now strong enough to welcome and explain some market trends. We have this Robot Market Focus conference, which actually Robotic Trends is participating to it, which is cool, where we're going to display more numbers, more market structure information. So I would definitely tell them, go into an association. Don't try to reinvent the wheel. Don't feel alone. You're not alone. And all together, we can probably go faster, if not better, including for your own sake and your own company.
Actually, I heard someone say earlier today, it was a very apt statement, like instead of trying to fight over pieces of the pie, let's make the whole pie bigger, and we can all have a piece of that. Do you agree with that?
I definitely agree with this. I think we're on this huge global exponential growth, which is robotic. If I hear the International Federation of Robotic number well, they say that the market is going to be multiplied by more than 30 in the coming 10 years. That's a big pie. Mm-hmm. But more than this, I think that a lot of people in robotics try to reinvent the whole thing, from OS up to, you know, almost manufacturing processes. Mm-hmm. We don't go this way. A lot of company, we recommend them to combine strengths. Mm-hmm. One company doing software, the other one doing vision, the last one doing mobility. And the production of a new robot should be an assembly, should be a gathering of expertise, rather than trying to reinvent the wheel over and over.
That sounds great. Well, Bruno, thank you very much for your time today. It's a tremendous show.
Thank you.
And I'm learning a lot by being here, and I'm glad we can participate. Thank you, Bruno.
Thank you very much for you coming.
Okay.
And I hope that we'll have more American next year.
We will. Thank you.